What's up guys, welcome back for another Yu-Gi-Oh! Pro Duel video. Yesterday I uploaded a new Dragon Maids video, Dragon Maid video. But again, the thing is that in this particular list, no Guard Dragons, no Red Eyes Darkness Metal Dragon. Let's face it, those two cards slash engines are high up on the ban list, the potential ban list that is for us TCG players. So, not including them here in this particular list. Running 41 cards, running pretty much a very similar strategy compared to yesterday because no Guard Dragons in the extra deck. I definitely want to add in Pot of Extravagance, definitely better than Pot of Desires in a deck. The whole deck feels like an engine, and it's very risky here, the Pot of Desires. Extravagance is also risky, banishing at least two. Worst case scenario, three fusions is terrible, but I think it's well worth it, right? Anyway, so the deck is more oriented towards the fusion, hence why I'm running the Polymerization at two. Three feels a bit too much, since you can always get it back free from your graveyard, and you know you're running like the Armageddon Knight. As for the ratios, some differences here. I dropped the Water one here from the main deck, and I'm only playing the level 2 Maid, Dragon Maid, the Water one also at 1. It has the Dante effect, random milling, and that's something I don't like. The random milling, you're never milling the cards you want, and that's why I prefer running less of those, and you know, other cards are just better here in the main. I want to keep the main deck count as low as possible. And as you saw, I'm still running the multiple Monster Reborn cards, the World Legacy Monster Reborn cards. They're in-themed Monster Reborn as well, and then the regular Monster Reborn. I think that's so solid. I think you have to... It's basically three pluses. The cards like Dragon's Ravine, and of course the Stratos, which has like a quote-unquote mill effect, you know, search something, discard something, and their Armageddonite are all monsters that... can immediately set up your Dragon Maid's monsters in your graveyard, and thanks to those multiple reborn cards, you can advance your game state. Again, very similar to Cosmos, special summoning, and in case of Cosmos, getting those smaller pilots on the field here. The same case, you want to get those low-level Dragon Maids, level 2, level 3, as soon as possible on the field, with at least like 2 or 3, whatever, and then you can start tagging out for the higher levels, and again, using cards like Dragon's Ravine, their quote-unquote fire stratos, their Armageddonite, you can set up your higher levels in your graveyard. Same for the fusion. The fusion also works very solidly here, using the materials from your hand, so potentially setting up your level 7, level 8 dragon mates, their dragon forms in your graveyard, right? The Erdi is at 3, it's the level 7 one, so I'm only running 3 of the level 7, no water, which is the other level 7 one, but Erdi, I think, is the best one. It's also the guy that has the quick effect, again, the level 7 with the quick effect, so during your opponent's turn, you can, let's say, discard your level 7 from the graveyard to special summon a Dragon Maid from your hand, and that can be good when your opponent wants to, wants to enter the battle phase. You can special summon something during your opponent's turn, triggering the effect, stag out, etc. So that's very, very important. So that's why Erdi here is at 3 here in the deck. As for the rest, again, the multiple Monster Reborn cards, Pot of Extravagance, giving the extra draws to work with. But again, the build is a little bit more focused on the fusion, using the tag out effects of your cards, of course. So again, very similar to Gladiator Beast, and then, you know, using the fusion, which is not once per turn, of each time when something is bounced back to your hand, you can pop a monster from your opponent. The fact that Hospitality, again, it's like a Monster Reborn with a Foolish Burial for the deck. It immediately sets up your graveyard with their bigger boss monster, right, and gets a small body on your side of the field. So again, solid what this deck tries to do. I'm not running their Continuous spell, I forgot its name. You know which one, it gives like a small attack boost, it also gives protection when it's sent to the graveyard. It might be okay when you use Parla's effect, which is the Armageddonite, to send that continuous spell from your deck to the graveyard to make your Dragon Maid monsters like unaffected, or they cannot be destroyed. I think that's the correct effect. The second effect might be okay, it's very similar to the Raid Raptor Continuous spell. Forgot the name, you know which one I mean, that as soon as there are two, at least two, Dragon Maids on your side of the field, you can get a Dragon Maid back from your graveyard. But I don't really like it that much. Like, during your opening 5, the card is useless. I'd rather it being like a reborn card, like the World Legacy reborn card, their in-themed reborn card. Those are just much better and basically do the same thing. Okay, you can get back like a dragon mate from your graveyard. That might be okay. Getting back there honest, for example, or getting like a smaller dragon mate, a low-level dragon mate back from your graveyard. But again, that's quote-unquote restriction. For example, of at least having two dragon mates on your side of the field feels a bit iffy. I'd rather, you know, just have one of the reborn cards and go from there, right? So I don't think it's needed just yet. Just yet. Also, you know, with the speed consistency, I want to give this deck, if it's starting, opening, or, you know, going second, you want to have as many tools as possible to advance your game state, or in case of Yu-Gi-Oh! In 2019, break your opponent's board, right? And that's what that continuous spell is not really doing, I feel. So again, going first, it's not hard to set up the fusion in the extra monster zone and then at least have one either level 2 or level 3 here on your side of the field, so you can use the fusion during each standby phase, targeting those lower levels dragon, lower level dragon mates monsters on your side of the field, and then special summon the other level from the low levels from your graveyard. So again, three pluses, very similar to Cosmos, getting as many low pilots, low ships, low pilots on your side of the field to, you know, use their effects, draw a card, well, yeah, search, set up your graveyard with their effects, mill some extra cards, but, and then, yeah, if your opponent tries to attend the battle phase, you can tag out, gain some more pluses after that. But the Darklaw ripped the fusion from my hand, and if I would have had any potential chance here of still being in a duel, that it would have been with the fusion, but nope, Darklaw. Darklaw just nukes this deck completely, right? Anyway, invoked, okay, that's cool. My opening hand, I'm already seeing the Erdi here in my hand, so I can potentially discard it and special summon something during my opponent's turn, but again, the potential Makaban Negate during my turn, I need that potential second summon on my side of the field. But the top deck of Impermanence, definitely solid, shuts down Makaba, so there is always a potential hand trap I have to play around, but no hand trap, so that's all fine. The fusion again pops the Makaba, getting some extra attacks, and here again, this is indeed game. Not really sure why the game is not... Well, I'm not really sure why the game is not ending here, but it doesn't really matter, right? It was game earlier, unless I'm mistaken. No, it was game. Anyway, last example, GBs again. So again, going first, using their hospitality, reborn something, and then send their dragon version, right, from their deck to the graveyard, fueling your engine. Going for the fusion, getting the Husky on my side of the field, targeting the level 3, special summon the Debris Dragon, which is the level 2 again, very convenient, this combo. Just gives you three low-level monsters on your side of the field. Ash Blossom feels kind of wasted, but I think I have to prevent the monster reborn from being searched. Most of the time, the monster reborn, right? Multiple Augustus, indeed, sets up Bestiary, and I believe Husky misses the timing for it to activate, you know, popping something from the opponent. But it's fine though, okay, Gazarus will only lead to, I think, one monster negation here in this situation. So I still have a chance, right, with the Monster Reborn in hand and the Debris Dragon in hand and another Monster Reborn. So again, multiple possibilities to play around this field. Something I could have done was to eventually get the Luft? You know, it's basically the Impermanence from the Archetype, the level 7, I think. Discard and then negate the monster effect from the opponent, an activated monster effect, that is. Does not negate Darklaw. But anyway, get the fusion on the field, and then some tagging out shenanigans. So double pop here with Husky, and then use the World Legacy card to put it in my main monster zone. Again, during the standby phase, establish my board, set up my graveyard, send the second copy indeed of the fusion. But again, yeah, this is more than enough, again, to attack for a game, right? So Husky again popping something, get a second copy of the fusion that sets up the low-level Dragon Mate, and then entering the battle phase and just tag out with all of the smaller dragon. So some extra pluses here. Fusion Father, Link Father maybe, but I'm happy with the build. Again, like always, feel free to leave suggestions. You know, in the OCG, they do have triple super rejuvenation, if I'm not mistaken, and that's quite important, so we might be getting that back as well. I've tested out the Tempest and Lightning. Basically does the same thing of setting up your smaller dragon mates in your graveyard for them to be reborn. But I don't like it. It takes up main deck space, and I'm not too keen here on Tempest, especially without the guard dragons. Destrudo again might be a main deck option thanks to or because of Dragon's Ravine, but without the card Dragons, I don't see much use for it. And again, I'm not a huge fan here of Dragon Maid's Reception, the continuous spell. I'd rather just be it like a Monster Reborn, one of those Monster Reborn-like cards. So again, like always, feel free to leave suggestions, and yeah, thanks for watching, and feel free to leave a comment or like if you enjoyed the video. Leetum signing out. Peace.